Hi, this is Gerd Leonhard, CEO of the Futures Agency and Futurist. I am in Johannesburg, South Africa today. Beautiful place here with a few colleagues who are also futurists. Let's do a short intro.
Thanks, Gerd. I'm Anton Musgrave, the joint CEO of Future World South Africa and a partner in Future World International.
I'm Neil Jacobson. I'm the other half of Future World CEO and also a partner in the international business.
And I'm Doug Vining, editor of Mind Bullets and also part of the Future World Network.
All right, so we're doing a gig tomorrow together, talking to a client about the future of business. So we figured we would just briefly talk about what we actually do as futurists, because there's common confusion about people, you know, predictions, crystal balls, and so on. So what does a futurist do?
I'm still trying to work that out.
Yes.
I think all of us have run businesses ourselves. All of us have been CEOs of companies and so forth. And one of the key things that has struck me now for many years is that the pressure of business means that you very seldom have a chance to look forward. And most CEOs are spending all of their time looking at today's operational issues. And that's what we try to break. Break the business as usual mindset and try to look forward into what's going to happen next.
Now, I think, Neil, it's about introducing executives to new conversations. If you think typically about the agenda in the boardroom, it's all about the next year to 18 months, etc. And this is really introducing a brand new debate to stretch the mind, to discuss things that would not normally be discussed in the context of what does the world look like that we are rushing towards, mostly with our noses buried in the sand.
And I think too, the big question of being a futurist is not being a fortune teller. We don't predict the future. What you do is explore possibilities for the future.
Yeah, I think one of the angles that I like to use, we've discussed earlier, it's very much the same, is to question assumptions and beliefs that may have been true in the past, but the future probably is going to be quite different, but also to sort of touch on things that are the obvious, but nobody wants to look at.
Yes.
And some of that work is rather painful. I don't know, your experience probably has been the same, is to discover that what you thought is true,
yeah,
may be true, may have been true, but no longer is.
And the rules have fundamentally changed. And I think it's how do you get someone to understand what lies beyond the next step change? We all think we understand the next step change, and many of us talk about these things that are coming at us. But the question is, so what happens after that? And what are the unusual linkages that you can make? And most importantly, what business opportunities flow from those? And what are the choices you would make as a strategic thinker if you are more in tune with what that world is going to be like?
I think it's also about broadening horizons. So many businesses focus on their business and their immediate competitors, the competitors that they know. But we all know that the world is flattening very, very rapidly. And new competitors are coming in that aren't the traditional players that you know.
Exactly.
And how do you get a chief executive and his team to lift their chins away from the business and look at the horizon, look at the world outside, and say, you know, where are the new competitors going to be? You know, what's Google going to do next in my field?
Yeah, it's a question of beyond the obvious.
Exactly.
And what's your take on this? I think this is also very hard for us to be beyond the obvious, because sometimes you have to be obvious, but
I think you're right, but it's also about embracing uncertainty, because one thing's for sure is that the future is uncertain, and people who think that the budgets and the plans are going to happen as planned are wrong, because the future is going to be different to what we expect, and being able to accept that and be happy with it, comfortable with it, that is a key factor.